supports this woman in her marriage today?
You may be seated. Well, here we are. On behalf of Mandy and Jeff, I want to thank you all for being here. After all, you have come from great distance to be here for them, and that makes a huge mark in their lives. It matters to them that you are here. Of all the people that they could have invited to this place for this day, you are the ones that have made the indelible mark on their lives. You're the friends and family that in a lot of ways have shaped them into the man and woman that stand before us today. And so because of that special role that you have in their lives, I want to give you all permission today. I want to give you permission to laugh. I want to give you permission to cheer. I want to give you permission to cry. Some of you have already gotten a head start on the crying part. But it's because that special bond that you all have with them. It's because of that emotional connection that you have with them. Many of you have had dreams for them for all of their lives. And this is a culmination of that dream. You get to see these two people link arms, link hands, and link lives as they bond together today in marriage. Would you pray with me? Father, we are so grateful for this couple. We're grateful for the time that they have had together, but also for the love story that we have seen emerge from their relationship. Father, would you allow us to see and be stirred by the bond that exists between the two of them as we take a trip down memory lane for how we got here, but as we also set our sights to the future and the dreams and hopes that even you have for them in their marriage. We are so grateful. Amen. Well, this did not happen overnight. There is a story for how you ended up here. So let's take a look back at that story. You know, they say that you only have one chance to make a first impression. Well, what was that first impression like? Their meeting was in a lot of ways by chance. They had mutual friends, and it just so happened that these mutual friends had orchestrated a night out on the town, and Mandy and Jeff just happened to be tagging along with those mutual friends. And so Jeff, not knowing what was going on in the situation, sees this blonde gal at the bar, and he's like, you know, I'm going to go up and talk to her, but it's got to be the right time. And so he waits for the right time, and the right time was when she was with her friends, having a joyful time at the bar, and he walks up and he introduces himself, and it worked. They start talking, they have a nice exchange, and before the night could even really get going, she just disappears. Jeff didn't even have a chance to ask for her phone number, and when I asked her, what was that about that first night, she's like, I didn't think much of it. We're just at a bar. I'm not going to sit around waiting for this guy to ask for my number. And so for all intents and purposes, the first impression was gone. Well, little unbeknownst to them, their other friends had made a connection and exchanged numbers, and not too long after that, they were at yet another chance encounter because two friends set up an evening out with friends. And at that point in time, Mandy saw Jeff walk across the room and said, well, there's a handsome guy. And so immediately they pick up where they had left off, and they keep talking and they keep talking, but yet Jeff does not ask for her phone number. So his second impression is also a good impression, but he does not find the step forward by asking her for her phone number. And only God could give you a third chance very shortly after that, which he did, and it was that night that you truly started to see the playful side of one another. You got a chance to share your first dance. You got a chance to actually get her phone number, and you even shared a kiss that evening. And it was that moment that your lives really took a change for the better. Now, you didn't jump into anything. You did take it slow. You guys were in the same city, but you were in different seasons of life. Mandy, you were just finishing an exhaustive schooling season, and you needed a little time to catch your breath. But now, Jeff, you knew a good thing when you saw it. And you're like, this is Chicago. I got to let her know where I'm coming from. I need her to know that I'm into her. And Jeff did something early on. He said, we need to define this relationship. He's like, I want you to be my girlfriend. That's girlfriend, boyfriend. I need to know that we're in this together. And Mandy kindly said, not yet, man. Not yet. I need a little bit more time. But I think that was an important step for you guys. Because so many times in life, we just jump into something because it's exciting. We jump into something because it's comfortable. But both of you honored each other's feelings. You honored your own feelings. You honored your own motivation. You let your intentions be known, Jeff. But Mandy, you also stood by your convictions saying, you know, I'm not there yet. And rather than spooking that you, Jeff, or feeling dishonored or feeling discouraged, you aligned yourself with Mandy. And this will be a extremely important trait in your relationship. Both of you finding your voice. Both of you being able to be secure enough in your own self, but being able to trust one another to say that what is true to your heart. And then, rather than getting upset, being able to find each other's rhythm, each other's pace, and honoring one another by aligning yourself. This is a journey. You both have taken a long journey. Since those early days, you have started to immerse your lives into each other's. You started to invest in each other in a variety of different ways, learning about one another, being able to cultivate unity in each other's, being able to make decisions together. Another trait that will serve you well in your years and years and years of marriage to follow. Both of you are an inspiration to us. For those of us who are married, we see each other, we see ourselves right where you are today, being reminded of what a special journey that is, of finding someone that you want to spend your life with. And all the steps, all the romance, all the strong desires, and it puts us back in a place to want that again. For those of us who are not married, you're an inspiration of what going after what you want looks like. Making sacrifices, being able to choose somebody else over your own personal needs and desires. It's an inspiration. And for all of us, you're an inspiration of what sacrifice looks like, what true commitment looks like, and what being able to love unconditionally looks like. Now, all those steps have landed you right here, in this place, with all your closest friends and family, wanting to give your lives to one another. But rather than hear that from me, I think we all deserve to hear it from you. So, Mandy, do you desire to marry Jeff and promise to love and support him all the days of your life?
I do.
And Jeff, do you desire to marry Mandy and promise to love and support her all the days of your life?
I do.
Those are good answers. So that's how we got here. Where are we going now? I have no wisdom to offer myself. The only wisdom I have comes from God's word. And I wanted to give you one particular verse out of the book of Ecclesiastes. It's a book of wisdom. It comes out of chapter 4. It says, two are better than one because they have a good return on their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. If two lie together, they will keep warm. Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not easily broken. You two have already experienced this. From the moment back in August of 2015 to this time, you've been experiencing the power of this verse. You are better together. You are individuals, but you are now combining your individual traits, talents, and skills to create something altogether new. You two do bring skills and talents into this relationship. But you also bring hurts, you also bring challenges, you also bring past wounds. And the beautiful part of God's design is that you no longer need to carry those by yourself. You two have been placed in each other's lives to shore those wounds up, to turn them from wounds into scars, and from those scars you can be strong. You two have been brought into each other's life to put together new patterns, healthy patterns, trustworthy patterns. And to the length that you do that, you too will be blessed. You will go further. It says that if one falls down, the other can help the other up. You two have someone that you can hold on to, an anchor in the storm, a safety net when you feel like you're falling, someone to pick you up and dust you off and put you back on firm ground, reassuring you that it's going to be okay. It also says that two can keep each other warm. This is a great picture of intimacy, not only physical intimacy, which is great, but also emotional intimacy. You're each other's safe harbors. In the craziness of this world, in the confusion of your day-to-day, you get to retreat home into one another's arms, the safest place you would ever want to be. You can keep each other warm. And it says that you can protect each other from harm. At this point, you know each other better than anyone in this room. Anyone in this venue, you know how you're each other's wired. You know how to hurt one another. You know how to guard one another. You know how to encourage one another. And I implore you to use that awareness to cultivate unity in your relationship. Protect one another from the harms that lurk around every corner. Protect one another from the things that would want to cause divisiveness in your marriage. You two are equipped and you're trained and you have been given the knowledge and you will do well. And this verse ends with just a very quaint verse. It says, a cord of three strands is not quickly broken. The author Solomon gently places this in there saying, and by the way, God is there for you to whatever degree you will include him. As you include God in your relationship, He will strengthen you even further, exponentially stronger. See, God wired you. Mandy, God made Jeff. He knows his every inner being, and God will whisper to you what Jeff needs to feel loved and respected in this relationship. Mandy, this is his daughter. He knows her as better than anybody. And his dreams for you guys are bigger than the dreams that you have for your own. His love for you each is bigger than the love that you have for each other. And he wants to see you excel. And as you include him in that, you will see just how powerful that bond will be. Now, this is true. These are true words. But what does it look like in practical day-to-day? So love and respect, I think all of us can agree, is a great foundation for any marriage to be built on. But how do you love and respect one another in the day-to-day normalcy of marriage? Well, I've given you some examples that you probably will experience sooner rather than later. Because when you do love and respect one another, fascinating things happen. You start to realize that this person will never hurt me, and I can let even more of my guard down because I know that this is the safest place. So this is what it looks like for Jeff and Mandy, because Jeff, you must love Mandy. When she needs a break and it's time for another girlfriend trip, like 7 days on some other continent, love your wife and let her plan her getaway. This is only a week without her. You will survive. And this brings her life, being with her girls. When it's time to pick out a new area rug for the living room, and she orders five, and they all show up on your doorstep, and she wants all of them unraveled and all of the furniture placed, love your wife. This is a process she has to go through because she wants to provide a warm and welcoming home for you. When she wants you to binge watch her favorite show, and you don't even like the show, it's okay, love your wife, go pop some popcorn, snuggle up and watch The Bachelor with her. It's not gonna kill you, and it will pay off for you in the long run. But Jeff, when Mandy's ambitions start to tug at her heart and her dreams can no longer be ignored, love your wife. Make whatever sacrifices you have to so that those dreams can become a reality. Now, Mandy, you must respect Jeff. When Jeff's had a long week and it's only Thursday, respect your husband. Let him head out for Thursday wing night with the fellas. He's going to recharge his battery. He's going to come back a better man. And when softball season comes around and he still thinks he's going to get a big contract, this is going to be his breakout year, respect your husband and let him have that time on the field. It's good for his mind and his body and his soul. And when he wants to show his love for his beloved Cowboys by converting the spare room into a cowboy corral, and he wants to do wall art, Ezekiel Elliott, full size, the cowboy star on the back wall. He wants to get some new furniture with the Dallas Star, the gray and blue. You respectfully tell him, not a chance. There are limits. And that room is not for your football frenzy. It's not for your fantasy league. It's for you and your future family to start to grow in the form of your children that will be coming along. Now, Mandy, when Jeff needs to make a tough decision, though, and he hears your heart on it, and he seeks wise counsel from many of the people that are here today, respect his instincts. His goal is to create the brightest, securest future for you and your family possible. Now, to solidify this union, you have written personal vows for one another. And these vows are to be read to one another. So, Mandy, at this point, I'm going to let you read your vows, and then we'll follow with some traditional vows.
Jeff, I promise to support you, encourage you, push you, and walk beside you. I promise to listen. I promise to always be your cheerleader and to cheer with you, even for the Cowboys. I promise to be fiercely loyal as your wife and as your friend. When we fight, I promise to remind myself why I love you and why I chose you as my life partner. I promise to trust you, even when it's hard. I promise to have your back, always. I promise to dance with you until we can't dance anymore. I promise to kiss you every night before bed, and I promise to love you forever.
And repeat after me, I, Mandy.
I, Mandy.
Take you, Jeff.
Take you, Jeff.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
All right, Jeff.
Mandy, I promise to be your biggest fan and celebrate your accomplishments and be your loyal teammate as we face life's challenges together. I promise to support you in your individual dreams and ambitions and cultivate our shared ones. I promise to comfort you on bad days and laugh and celebrate with you on joys. I promise to be your partner in all adventures, whether that be exploring new places around the world or exploring new pizza places in our city. I promise to not take life too seriously and to be open to spontaneous opportunities. I promise to take care of you when you're sick or hungry. I promise to give all of myself to you. And I promise to respect you, to honor you, and to love you unconditionally for all of our lives.
I, Jeff, take you, Mandy.
I, Jeff, take you, Mandy.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
To seal these promises, the couple has purchased rings to exchange. Now, the rings are made from the most valuable materials that we know of. Precious metals, precious gems. They are truly of great value. But what makes them of real value is not what they're made of, it's what they are a symbol of and who they are a gift from. And so as you take these rings and you place them on each other's fingers, I want you to forever know that you've been chosen, that someone has looked at you and said, you are the one. I choose you to do this crazy life with. I choose you to give myself to. So at this time, Jeff, go ahead and take her ring. Place it on her finger. And repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I choose you.
I choose you.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
And take his ring. Place it on his finger. With this ring.
With this ring.
I choose you.
I choose you.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
Would you pray with me? Lord, as you hear these promises of your kids, this woman and man who are pledging their lives to one another, would you give them the insight that is necessary to carry out these promises? Would you give them the discernment and the wisdom that is well beyond their capacity to know what is the other needing to feel loved and respected? Father, would you bless everything they touch? Would you bless their relationship with each other, but also the relationships within their communities, their friendships? Would you bless their careers? And would you bless their families as they grow old, seeing their children's children grow, and the legacy that they take from their parents as they pass that on to their children and see that legacy unfold before their very eyes. Bless them and keep them. And we pray these things in your precious name. Amen. Well, Jeff, are you ready to kiss your bride?
Amen.
All right, well, hold on a second. It is my honor to pronounce you husband and wife. Jeff, you may now kiss your bride. Again. Yeah. All right, let's go ahead and grab your bouquet. Friends and family, ladies and gentlemen, for the very first time ever, it is my honor to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jeff Kolodkin. Congratulations, guys.